Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. So we have completed the eight limbs of yoga. And therefore, one point still remains. Yoga means what?
瑜伽是什么?
So, that is Samyama.
瑜伽是Samyama.
When the mind is perfectly controlled with reference to time, space and object together, then that state of the mind is called as yoga.
我们的意识的状态是在时间、空间和对象的维度上完全都受掌控的那一个状态，就是瑜伽的状态。
Now, what is the difference between the controlled mind and a parked mind?
Parked.
It is parked somewhere.
一个受控制的意识和我们只是把意识放到了一边有什么区别？
Like if somebody tells me, I have got perfect control over the car.
就好像有人跟老师说，我是完全可以控制我的车的。
I said, okay, let's go on the Himalayas, rough roads to drive.
然后我们说，好吧，那我们上喜马拉雅的山坡上来开一开。
He said, no, no, I just parked the car in the garage.
就说没有，我只是把我的车停在我的车库里。
Parking the car in the garage is not the control over the car.
你可以把车停在车库里，留在那里，不是对车的完全的掌控。
In the same manner,
同样的,
control of the car mind does not mean your mind is quiet.
对意识的控制不是说你的意识就只在那里安静的。
Controlled mind is that mind
一个受控制的意识是
which is able to negotiate through all the problems of life
是可以在问题当中找到解决路径的。
And therefore we should not have that wrong notion. Yoga means you should not move, you should not talk, you should not think. That is not yoga.
所以不要有这个错误的认识，瑜伽就是坐在这里一动不动，一声不吭，什么也不想。
If we misunderstand sitting in one posture for a long time without movement is yoga,
如果我们错误的认为瑜伽就是坐在一个体式当中持久稳定的不变，
then all the buffaloes are the great yogis.
那么那些水牛都是很好的瑜伽士。
Not talking, absolutely keeping quiet, if that is yoga,
如果完全的静默就是瑜伽的话,
then the snakes don't talk.
那些蛇也不会说话,
so they'll become great yogi.
他们也是伟大的瑜伽士吗?
Not getting disturbed by anything, if that is yoga,
如果不会受到任何事情的干扰就是瑜伽的话,
then every dead body is a yoga.
那每一个死尸都是很好的瑜伽士。
That is not the meaning of yoga.
这都不是瑜伽的意义。
We live dynamically in this world,
我们在这个世界当中动态地生活着,
go through all the ups and downs,
经历生活的高高低低起起伏伏,
and yet our equipoise is perfectly maintained.
但是我们的那个水平点还是非常完美地被保持着。
That condition of the mind is called as Rutambara Prajna.
这个状态老师说的烦烦的就是我们要达到那个高级的状态。
Rutambara Prajna means intuitive knowledge.
这他老师说的梵文的意思就是直觉的智慧。
In intuitive knowledge, we go beyond cause and effect.
在直觉的智慧当中是超越因果的。
There are two types of people, those who are intelligent and those who are intellectuals.
有两类人，有一类人是智性的，然后有一类人是智慧的，听老师解释一下。
Those who are intellectuals, they are intelligently miserable.
Intelligent, reasonable.
Intelligently miserable.
Intelligently miserable. 那些智力很高的人，他们是很聪明的，受苦着。
And those who are intelligent people, they are never miserable.
还有一类非常有智慧的人，他们是不受苦的。
Therefore, we should not think about yoga means everything is perfectly all right and then we are happy.
所以我们不要认为瑜伽就是一切都是完美的状态下我们就是快乐的。
We are able to accept the life as it is presented to us.
无论生活以什么样的形式展现给我们，我们都可以接受它。
As a result, we stop our old habit of reacting to every situation.
结果是我们不再以过去的习惯对世界起反应。
Then instead of reacting, we start acting.
我们不起反应，而是我们做正确的行为。
Now this process of acting is going within.
这个正确的行为就是要往内寻。
How do we go within?
怎么样往内走呢?
Going within is the effect goes back to cause.
也就是说我们的果要回到因。
How the ornament will go back to the gold?
我们已经做好了这个首饰，怎么再回到它还是一块金块的状态呢?
Is the ornament and the gold separate?
如果金块跟首饰是分开的。
Gold with name and form,is called as ornament.
这个金块，一个有形状、有名称的金块，它就是一个首饰。
Like this object goes in my pocket.
就像老师的那个东西回到老师的口袋里。
In the same manner, the ornaments will not go inside the gold.
这个同样的方式，这个首饰不会以那样的方式回到金块当中去。
Now to discover the gold in ornament, is it necessary that we have to melt them?
想要在金块当中找到首饰，我们是不是要把金块融化
？No, we have to simply remain indifferent to the name and the form.
我们不用的，我们只要认知到它们两者深刻的连接是同一物质。
Then we go to the gold.
然后我们就来到了金块。
In the same manner.
同样的。
The process of going within is the effect is dissolved in the cause.
我们向内走的方式也是让我们的这个果再回到因。
Now this principle I'll explain you through one example.
老师通过一个例子来解释一下。
All the colors and forms are the effects.
我们所有的颜色跟形状都是果。
And the cause is our vision.
因是我们的眼视觉。
For a blind person, there are no colors, there are no forms.
对于盲人来说，没有颜色，也没有形状。
So where from the colors and forms come?
颜色跟形状从何而来？
They come from the vision.
从视觉而来。
The second principle.
第二个原则。
Vision is one, and colors and forms are many.
视觉只有一种，但是颜色跟形状有多种。
So cause is one, effects are many.
所以因是一个，但是果可能有很多。
So, what is the cause of the sense organs, which are five?
我们这五大感官器官的因是什么呢？
What is the cause of the sense organs of action, which are again five?
我们这五大行动器官的因是什么呢？
So, the cause of these ten organs is one, and that is mind.
这十个器官的因都是一个，都是同一的，就是我们的意识。
So, when...Mind comes out of the eyes, it is called as vision.
当我们的意识通过眼睛而出来的话，我们就叫它视觉。
And vision can see only colors and forms.
然后我们的视觉只能看到颜色跟形状。
Vision cannot hear the sounds.
我们的视觉是不能够听的。
So all sense organs are object specific.
所以每一个感官对象都是每一个感官都有它自己可以去互动的对象。
But their cause, the mind is common for all.
但是他们的因的这个意识是一对多的。
So what will be dissolving the sense organs in the mind?
所以什么是把我们的感官器官再融回到我们的意识当中呢？
Only knowing that.It is the mind alone which is called as the vision.
只是知道它，在意识层面知道它，我们叫它一个愿景。
It is like the man alone is called as husband.
所以一个男人，我们可以称他为丈夫。
So is it that the husband has come out of the man?
是说丈夫以物理的形态从这个男人身上出来了吗？
So that miserable husband, if he has to become happy, does he have to take divorce?
那么那个倒霉的丈夫，他想要再开心的话，他必须要离婚吗？
Only he has to remember this much.
他只需要记住这么多。
That by birth he is a man.
他出生的时候是一个人。
And by accident he is a husband.
然后呢， 不巧的事情，他恰巧变成了一个丈夫。
And whenever there is accident, there is pain.
那每次我们有事故，有意，他生出是人，他意外的变成了一个丈夫。每次有意外的时候，我们都是痛苦的。
So accept the pain cheerfully.
所以快乐的接受痛苦。
Get this point is very simple.
能够真正理解这一点。
So we leave the object, we come to the sense organs.
所以我们现在离开感官对象，来到感官器官。
We leave the sense organs, we come to the mind.
然后我们离开感官器官，再来到意识。
No, mind is likes and dislikes.
然后意识就是喜欢跟不喜欢。
And we have to leave the mind and come in intellect.
所以我们要离开意识，来到智性。
Intellect is the place of wisdom.
智性是我们智慧所存在的地方。
Now the question is,
现在的问题是
who is guiding our life?
那是谁在主导着我们的生活
？Is it the mind that is guiding our life, or is it the wisdom that is guiding the life?
是我们的意识在主导我们的生活，还是智慧在主导我们的生活
？If the wisdom is guiding the life, we will not be miserable.
如果智慧在主导我们的生活，我们是不会在生活中受苦的。
If the mind is guiding the life, we will not be happy.
如果意识在主导我们的生活，我们是无法快乐的。
What is the process of going within?
所以我们往内走的路径是什么
？First, worldly objects cannot enslave me.
首先，外在的世界、物质的世界是没有办法奴役我的。
And therefore, give yourself minimum choice.
所以给自己极少的选择。
We have conquered one barrier.
我们就把一层的障碍已经克服了。
Now we are come to the mind, to the sense organs.
然后呢，我们从感官对象来到了感官器官。
Now let us not be a slave to the sense organs.
我们也不要成为感官器官的奴役。
And for that, do some experiments in life.
然后呢，在这一点上做一些生活当中做实验。
Try for 1 month, don't take salt.
比如说，尝试一个月完全不吃盐。
Initially.The tongue will start troubling you.
最开始的时候，舌头会给你带来很多麻烦。
And then say nothing doing. If you don't eat, don't eat. Who cares?
然后呢，过一段时间就说你不想吃就不想吃，谁在乎呢
？In few days time, your tongue will accept.
过几天以后，你的舌头就会接受。
It's very simple.
非常的简单。
Take a firm resolution.
下一个非常坚定的愿。
That on any one day in a week,
一周中的一天
you are not going to go to Youku or WeChat.
这一天完全不上优酷或者微信
One day in a week,
一周的一天
Then what will I do?
那我这一天干嘛呀
Then you will come to know.That without Youku and WeChat, you still are alive.
然后你就会发现，没有优酷，也没有微信，你还是活着的。
Thus, discover freedom.
发现自由。
Don't be a slave.
不要变成奴隶。
Then we come from the sense organs. We have come to the mind.
然后我们从感官器官来到意识。
Now, when we come to the mind.Again, we are victims of likes and dislikes.
在意识这个层面，我们就是喜欢和不喜欢的受害者。
So let us observe whether we are living under the influence of the likes and dislikes, or we are living under the guidance of the wisdom.
所以在这个层面，我们要做的是观察自己是否是在自己的喜好下面生活着，还是自己是在智慧下面生活着。
And what is the wisdom?
智慧是什么
？Wisdom is.Whether I like or not, that is not important. What is important is whether this is right or wrong. That is important.
智慧就是我喜欢或者不喜欢不重要，重要的是这个事情是对还是错。
For example, early to bed and early to rise is the way to be healthy, wealthy and wise is right.
比如说早睡早起身体好是对的。
But early to bed and early to rise is the way to be happy, healthy and wise. I don't like.
但是早睡早起身体好，我不喜欢。
Now you decide who is ruling your life.
现在你决定谁在控制你的生活。
Likes and dislikes or wisdom.
喜欢不喜欢还是智慧。
You have to choose yourself.
你自己要去做选择。
If you observe within yourself,
如果你自己内在观察的话
，We are all the victims of our personal likes and dislikes.
我们全部都是我们个人喜好的受害者。
And then when something good happens, we are ha ha.
好事情发生的时候，我们好开心。
When something bad happens, ooh.
坏的事情发生的时候，我们很悲哀。
And is constantly buffeting up and down, up and down.
所以我们一天的生活都是起起伏伏的。
And in both the cases, the equipoise of our mind is destroyed.
在这两个，在喜欢和不喜欢的这两者，我们的水平点都是失衡的。
We have to maintain the equipoise under all conditions.
我们要在任何的情况下都保持自己的那个水平点的平衡。
And this can be done only when we start living under the umbrella of wisdom.
只有当我们在智慧的大伞下面生活，我们才可以达成。
And when we start living with this understanding, how do we know whether we are going the right way or the wrong way?
我们已经开始这样练习了，我们怎么知道自己的这个生活方式是对还是错呢？
Our attention will be on the quality of our mind all the time.
我们的注意力应该一直都集中在自己意识的品质上。
Nothing should disturb our mind.
没有事情应该可以来干扰我们的意识。
And then you will discover one day.
有一天你会发现。
Disturbed mind is pain.
受干扰的意识就是痛苦。
An undisturbed mind is peace.
没有受干扰的意识就是平静。
And this is what is called a pure mind.
这个就是我们所谓的纯净的意识。
And in that pure mind, then the inquiry kindles.
就在这个纯净的意识当中，真正的问询才会被点燃。
Now there are no more questions about the world.
然后就对这个世界就没有任何问题了。
Now there are no questions. Now there is inquiry.
这里面没有问题，有问询。
And then the first thing that will happen is we will be able to analyze not why there are miseries, but we'll be able to analyze who is miserable.
然后我们才可以开始分析，不是为什么这里有痛苦，而是谁在经历痛苦。
Then you will discover that at the root of every misery, there is somebody.
然后我们就会发现，在那个痛苦的根源，总是有一个人或者一个角色。
Then the next step.
在下一步。
Where from this somebody has come?
这个人或这个角色从何而来？
Then again, it will click one day by God's grace.
然后某一天在上帝的加持下就会突然一下又顿悟了。
That somebody is born after body identification.
有一天某人可以超越对身体的附着再次诞生。
Therefore, what is the yoga life?
那么瑜伽的生活是什么？
We are no more living as the body, but we are living through the body.
瑜伽的生活就是我们不再以我们自己就是身体的生活方式生活，而是使用身体再生活。
It is for this purpose that all the eight limbs are practiced.
就是由于有这个目的，所以我们练习瑜伽的八支。
After we have come to Samyama,
当我们到达 Samyama 最高的那个境界了。
Now we apply that controlled mind in this inquiry.
然后呢，我们就用那个受到控制的意识来这里问询。
On what ground I say I am the body?
在什么样的基础下我说我就是我的身体？
We have not created our body.
我并没有创造我们的身体。
Our body doesn't listen to us.
我们的身体也不聆听我们。
And yet I am body.
但是我们还是我们的身体。
And we think we are intelligent.
然后我们以为我们自己很聪明。
Therefore, we are told you are not the body, but somebody expressing through the body.
所以我们被告知，我们不是我们的身体，而是某些人格通过身体而表达自己。
Then we come to know there are so many bodies expressing through the body.
然后就会发现有很多不同的人格通过不同的身体来表达他们自己。
When in front of the Father, It is the son expressing through the body.
在父亲面前是儿子这一个角色通过身体表现出来。
Even in front of the wife, it is the husband expressing through the body.
在妻子面前是丈夫这个角色表现出来。
If it is in front of the son, then the father is expressing through the body.
在儿子面前是父亲这个角色表现出来。
So as a body, I had to play so many roles.
一个身体就需要扮演很多角色。
So we play all the roles perfectly well.
所以我们完美的尽自己应该去扮演的那个角色。
But after the role is over, come back to your body.
但是你的角色扮演完了以后，你再回到你的身体。
Don't hold on to the same thing.
不要抓住同样的东西永远不放。
All the time worried about the children.
永远担心孩子
All the time worried about the husband or the wife
永远担心自己的伴侣
All the time worried about the parents
永远担心自己的父母
Now who can help you?
谁能够帮助你
Play your role perfectly well and learn to withdraw instantaneously
好好的扮演应该扮演的角色然后呢知道在该收回的时候立即收回
We must have freedom to increase the speed of the carAnd to stop the car.
我们必须有能力开车的时候要加速的时候马上加速要停车的时候立即停车。
Once I was driving in USA.
有一次老师在美国开车。
And being an Indian, to break the rule is my birthright.
作为印度人来说 不按规矩行事是老师天生的权利。
So it was the morning time.
是一个早上的时间。
And it was a holiday.
而且是个节假日。
So although it was a red light, I said anyway, nobody is watching, I went.
然后当时是个红灯，但是周围一辆车一个人都没有，老师就闯红灯了。
And the police was waiting for me.
然后呢，警车就在旁边藏着等着老师。
He stopped.
他就停了。
He said, I show your driving license.
他跟老师说，把你驾照拿来给我看看。
I showed him.
你给他看了。
He said, you have a driving license. Why didn't you stop the car?
那个警察说你有驾照啊你怎么不知道红绿灯的时候要停车呢
So I said, sir, I have a driving license. I don't have a stopping license.
他说我有驾驶证我没有停车证。
Then I said, like this thing, although he was a police, he laughed.
虽然说他是一个警察当时也笑了。
He said, man, you made my day today.
然后那个警察说、啊、你这一天点亮了我的一天。
Okay, go this time, but never do again.
然后警察把老师放走了，你以后再也不要这么做了，这次让你过去。
I said, sir, I have come across the best policeman in my own life.
你是我这辈子遇到最好的警察。
Now tell me, when you have a driving license, it includes stopping of the car also, is it not?
所以当我们有驾照的时候，它是不是包括了我们停车的能力呢
？Therefore, life doesn't mean only getting in the world.
所以。生活不是说我们只要入世。
We have to have the freedom to withdraw from the world.
我们还要有能力该出世的时候要出世。
And when we are not able to withdraw, we commit accidents.
如果我们在该出世、该出来的时候不出来的话，那我们就会创造意外。
And then blame, oh God, why did it happen to me?
然后呢，就会埋怨上帝，为什么这样的事情会发生在我身上
？As much it is necessary.To get involved in the world, that much it is necessary to withdraw from the world.
融入到这个世界的重要性和我们可以从这个世界当中抽离的重要性同等重要。
A perfect balance between involvement and withdrawal is living in meditation.
一个完美的平衡，关于入世和出世的平衡，就是一个发展了的这个最好的意识。
Otherwise, we'll be all the time doing so many things and frustrated.
不然的话，我们就会在每一个时刻都操办着无数的事情，但是在受苦。
Therefore, friends, spiritual life is not only sitting quiet with the eyes closed or getting too much involved in the world. Maintain a perfect balance between involvement and withdrawal.
所以灵性的生活不是就安安静静的坐在这里，什么都不做，什么都不说，什么都不想，也不是完完全全的就把自己完全的融入到了社会当中，而是在这两者之间找到完美的平衡。
Like what is a good driving?
什么是一个好的司机？
When we are able to go in a speed when it is possible, and when we have to go slow, we can go slow also comfortably.
当我们可以快速开车的时候以最快的速度前行，当我们需要减速的时候也可以及时减速，就是一个好的司机。
Once I was going with my friend in South Africa.
在南非和一个朋友在一起。
And he was an old man.
他也是一个年迈的人。
And he was driving so slow.
他开得非常的慢。
I said, come on, man, go, the road is free, go fast.
然后老师跟他说，这路上一个人都没有，你磨磨蹭蹭的做什么？
He said, how does it matter? You go slow.
然后那人就说，有什么必要吗？我们就慢慢开吧。
Then I thought, how to inspire this person?
我就想，怎么样能够激发一下这个人？
Then I told him, let us play some game.
来，他说，让我们做一些游戏吧。
He said, what game can we play?
我们玩什么游戏呢？
He said, whatever next car passes next us, you have to tell the age of the driver.
然后老师就说，下面有一个车超过我们的时候，你要告诉我那个司机是几岁了。
So one car passed.
有一个车超过去了。
I said, tell me the age of the driver.
然后老师问他那人几岁。
He said, how can you tell like that?
那他又说，我怎么能够这样就知道呢？
I said, I can tell.
老师说，我知道。
I said, his age was 25.
他25岁。
Second car went.
第二个车又开过去了。
He said, now tell his age.
然后老师说，多少岁？
I said, he is 45.
他是45岁。
Third car went.
第三个车过去了。
What is his age?
他多少岁呢？
60.
60岁。
He said, how can you say like that?
然后那人就说，你是怎么猜的？
I said, there is a formula.
这是有没有个公式的？
The speed of the car is inversely proportionate to the age of the driver.
车速跟年龄成反比。
When there is a possibility, live dynamically.Where it is not possible, be cool.
当有机会的时候，就要非常活跃、动感的去接受这个机会，去尝试这个机会。当没有机会的时候，就很平稳的。
Don't be goody 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 on the time.
What is goody 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 goody?
Showing that I am superior than others.
老是觉得自己比别人要好。
There are many people, they have got this funny notion. Spirituality means I don't laugh.
很多人就这样的啊，灵性就是我不会笑。
I don't go here and there.
我不去这里，也不去那里。
I don't go to the hotels.
我不去那个餐馆吃饭。
I sit all the time in meditation.
我总是静坐在冥想当中。
And go to sleep.
在冥想当中睡觉。
Be normal.
做正常的人。
Spiritual evolution is not becoming someone extraordinary.
灵性修行的这条路不是让我们成为超常或者不正常的人。
And in this manner, when you start living your life under the umbrella of wisdom, your life will be totally different.
在这样的智慧的这个引导下，我们的生活会变得非常的自由。
Now we will conclude the remaining questions.
我们现在完成剩下的问题。
Is there the soul mate?
有灵魂伴侣吗？
Yes, there is.
有。
Like for every shoe, there is a soul.
就好像每一个鞋里面都有一个鞋底一样。
In the same manner, for every person, there is a soul mate.
就每一个人也有一个鞋底一样。
And when the sole of the shoe goes away, the shoe is useless.
当鞋底掉下来了，鞋就没有用了。
Friends, this is a path by the one, to the one, all alone, without getting lonely.
Wow, 我们这一条道路是一个我们必须要一个人前行的道路，但是这条路一点都不孤单。
When you have to sleep,
当你要睡觉的时候。
Will I go and tell Tina? Tina, I have to sleep. Please come.
老师想要睡觉的时候会跟我说我要睡觉了，你过来。
The children tell to their mother, is it not?
小宝宝会这样跟父母说，不是吗
？Mummy, mummy, I have to sleep. Please come.
他们会说妈妈妈妈，我要睡觉，来陪我睡觉。
Now the mother doesn't sleep. The child has to sleep alone.
妈妈不会睡觉，孩子要自己睡觉。
Be attentive. What is sleep?
什么是睡觉？
In sleep, the one who sleeps disappears.
在睡觉，那个睡觉的人会消融。
Now don't sleep, I'll tell you.
现在先别睡呢，老师要告诉你们。
When we go to sleep, exactly what happens?
我们睡觉的时候到底发生了什么？
We withdraw from the whole world.
我们从这个世界当中抽离。
We are in our house.
我们在我们的房间里。
Withdraw from the whole house.
我们在从房间当中抽离。
We are below our quilt.
我们在钻到被子下面。
Lights are switched off.
灯都关上了。
Phone is kept away.
电话也放到一边。
And then only one mantra goes on.
只有一个咒语在念着。
I want to sleep. I want to sleep. I want to sleep.
我想要睡觉，我想要睡觉，我想要睡觉。
And then when this I and the want they disappear, the sleep begins even in the satsang.
我想要睡觉。当我 I want to sleep. 当我和睡觉消失的时候，睡眠就发生了。I want sleep.我和睡觉消失的时候。
So till such time,
他说的是睡觉吧？想要，想要 ，OK。
Till such time, I is there, the sleep doesn't begin.
只要我还在，睡觉就不可能发生。
If this is true for a simple thing like a sleep,
对睡觉这样简单的事情来说
，If we have to merge in the absolute,
我们要回到无限当中去。
How there can be a mate?
那怎么能够有伴侣呢？匹配呢
？Soul mate is a perverted spirituality.
所以灵魂伴侣是一个不正常的灵性修行的概念。
They cannot think of being alone.
因为他们没有办法孤单。
All the time, what somebody is required.
总是要跟某人在一起。
Useless fellows.
没有用的人们。
Discover to be alone.And never feel lonely in life.
可以一个人，但是不需要孤单寂寞。
Such people who are constantly dependent on somebody, they are lonely in the crowd.
那些永远要依托他人的人，哪怕是在人群当中，他们都是孤单寂寞的。
Because they are not able to merge with everybody.
因为他们没有办法融入到所有人当中。
They want only their soul mate.
他只想要他们的灵魂伴侣。
And if the soulmate goes, the soul is useless.
然后，如果他们的灵魂伴侣离开了，灵魂就没有用了。
Don't do that.
不要这样做。
Are all the persons the same
to me?
To me.
这是后半个问题，也是所有的人对于我来说都一样吗
？Yes, all the people are same to me because it is the same electricity functioning through all the bulbs.
是的，所有人对于我来说都是一样的，因为都是同一个电流走过同所有的灯泡。
Will the electricity say, "Oh, this bulb is giving light in the temple, therefore he's a good bulb"?
那个。
And this bulb is giving light in the toilet, therefore bad bulb.
因为这个电流会说，这个灯泡在寺院里面，所以这个灯泡就是个好灯泡；这个灯泡在厕所里面，所以就是个坏灯泡。
Now apply subjectively.
所以非常主观的把这个也应用过来。
If I see something beautiful with my eyes,
如果我的眼睛看到一个美丽的东西
，or if I see something dirty with my eyes,
让我看到眼睛看到一些污秽的东西
，are the eyes becoming beautiful or dirty?
我的眼睛会因为我所见变得美丽或者污秽吗
？Where are the differences?
区别在哪里
？Therefore.Change your vision, the world will change.
所以改变我们的视觉，这个世界就会改变。
Same
second
problem.
Second question.
Okay.
First one is done.
God or?
Are the supreme reality exist? Does God or other
really exist?
Really exist.
You find out.
上帝或者其他更高至上存在真的存在吗？老师说你自己去找一找。
Even if I tell you, you will say, "What is the proof?"
即使老师告诉你某一个答案，你也会问老师你怎么向我证明
？One young boy asked me, "Have you seen God?"
有一个年轻的孩子问老师，你见过上帝吗
？I said, "Okay. What do you understand by the word God?"
然后老师就问那个孩子，你对上帝这个词怎么理解
？God is love.
然后那孩子就说，上帝就是爱啊。
What is love?
爱是什么
？Love is God.
爱就是上帝。
We use the word without any understanding of the meaning of the word.
我们在应用这些词汇，但是其实我们并没有理解词汇的含义。
I had two daughters.
有两个女儿。
One was grown up, other was small.
一个已经长大了，一个还未成年。
And the elder daughter was getting married.
然后这个大女儿要结婚了。
And therefore there was lot of commotion in the house.
所以这个家里面都有很多的事情。
And the marriage ceremony was going on.
婚礼在进行着。
And a small girl, she was worried. What is happening everywhere?
然后那个年轻的女儿就说：“这怎么了？有点担心，发生了什么？”
So she asked somebody.
她就问某人
：“What is happening to my sister?”
我的姐姐怎么了？她发生什么事情了
？”And who is that boy?
那个男的是谁？
Oh, she is getting married to him.
然后呢，人家就跟小女儿解释：“哦，你的姐姐要跟这个男士结婚。”
So what?
然后呢
？No, after marriage, they will go for a honeymoon and enjoy.
然后他们结婚了以后就会去度蜜月去享受。
Really?
然后小女儿说：“啊，真的。”
She came running to me.
然后她跑到老师这里来。
Dad, let us get married.
爸爸，我们结婚吧。
And we'll go for a honeymoon.
然后我们去度蜜月。
And we'll enjoy.
然后我们去享受。
Now that child, what she understands the meaning of marriage?
她理解婚姻的定义吗
？If she understands the meaning of marriage, will she ever say thing to me like that?
如果她理解了婚姻的概念的话，她会找她的父亲去说。
In the same manner, we say God, God, God. What do you understand by the word God?
所以同样的方式，我们就在说上帝，上帝，上帝。我们其实理解上帝的含义吗
？See, my friends, what we do not know, we have to have blind faith.
我们不知道的，我们必须对他保有信仰。
Now tell me, do we know from which mother's womb we have fallen in this world?
我们知道我们是从哪一个妈妈的子宫里面爬出来的吗
？Somebody tells, this is your mother.
有人就告诉我们，这个是你的妈妈。
Do we say, where is the DNA proof?
我们会说，你给我 DNA 验证。
We accept.
我们就接受，我们不会。
Then that mother whom we accepted blindly.She tells this man is your father.
然后那一个我们已经接受了，就是我们妈妈的人告诉我们，这个是你的父亲。
Don't we accept?
我们就接受，不是吗
？Because the rule is, in the field of ignorance, the faith is the strength. It is not a weakness.
因为在无明当中，在黑暗当中，信仰在这样的状态下是力量，而不是懦弱。
So when the wise people tell that the supreme reality exists, you have to begin from there.
所以，当那些先贤、那些智者告诉我们一个更高的至上的存在是存在的，那么我们就要从那里开始。
I'll tell you a beautiful story.
有一个非常美丽的故事。
There was one man who came to my house.
有一个人来到老师的家里。
And he asked me,
他问老师
Is it the house of Swami Anubhavananda?
他说这个是 Swami 老师的房子吗
I said, no.
我说不是
Go ask somebody else.
去问问其他人
He went to the next house.
他就去到邻居的房间
And he asked, hey, I want to see the house of Swami Anubhavananda. Which is the house?
我想看 Swami 老师的房子哪个是他的房子
So he again came to my house and knocked the door.
然后呢，又被指挥到我的房间，又来敲门。
He said, "This is the house of Swami Anubhavananda, is it not?"
然后那个人就来问我，这就是 Swami 老师的房子，不是吗
？I said, "No, man. I told you this is not his house."
然后我就跟他说，这不是那个 Swami 的房间，我跟你说了刚才。
He went on asking about a dozen houses.
他又问了得有六七个房子。
And everybody told him the same thing. This is the house of Swami Anubhavananda.
每一个人都跟他说，就是这个房间。
Then I told him.
然后我跟他说。
You knew all of them?
你认识他们吗
？No.
他说我不认识。
When they told this is the house of Swami Anubhavananda, didn't you believe blindly?
但是当他们告诉你这个就是你要找的 Swamiji 的房子的时候，你是不是就接受了呢
？When to know a simple thing in this world, we have to believe in what others tell.
所以这样的事情我们可以接受。那么当其他的事情也同样被告知的时候
then only you can reach the destination.
所以，因为只有这样，在我们没有办法自己直见的情况下
，Suppose we say no, I don't trust you.
接受引导，我们才能够达到终点。
Then you will never reach anywhere.
如果我们就说我不接受，那你就永远没有办法到达任何地方。
Therefore, whether the supreme exists or not, you find out and tell me also.
所以，这个至上的存在到底是否存在，你去找到，然后你回来告诉我。
You said less choice can be made can make us happy.But if we don't explore enough choices, how can we guarantee we will not regret. Example, dating, different people can help us know which type is more problematic, no, more suitable, and also help us know them better.
Ourselves better.
See?
就是老师说我们不要有太多的选择，但是如果我们不去很多的尝试，我们怎么知道什么是适合自己的？比如说不多约会几次，怎么知道谁适合做我们的老公呢？而且这一个过程，我们也会知道更多的了解自己。
Two persons,
两个人
husband and wife,
丈夫跟妻子
they never stay together because of love.
他们永远都不是因为爱而在一起。
That love business is over within 1 or 2 years of marriage.
结婚以后一两年那个爱就消失了。
They stay together because of understanding.
他们在一起是因为理解。
And in understanding, we must compete how much I can sacrifice.
那么在理解之下，我们要知道自己可以牺牲付出多少。
And in your dating business, you try to find out how much I can encash.
但是当我们在去约会的时候，我们要看的是我们可以从对方身上获得多少。
This happened in USA.
在美国就是这样。
I was invited in some South Indian family.
然后老师被请到了一个这个南印度的一个家庭。
And when I went to their house, their young daughter, she looked at me and spoke to her parents.
然后他们年轻的女儿看着老师，就跟他们女儿的父母在说话。
And she said, "Okay, today you brought this guy to talk to me."
那女儿跟家长说，今天你来带了这么一个人来跟我说话。
And she said, "I am an American girl. I will be straightforward to you."
I will what?
Straightforward to you.
Straightforward. 她说我是美国人，所以我会对你很直接。
I said, "Okay, I'm also Indian Swami. I'll also be straight to you."
就说我是一个印度的 Swami， 我也可以跟你很直接。
Then she asked the same question.
然后他就问了一个同样的问题。
What is wrong if I go for dating?
如果我去约会的话，有什么错吗
？I said, "You please, if you are intelligent enough."
如果你足够聪明的话。
Who is an intelligent person?
什么是聪明的人
？He who learns from the mistakes of others.
从别人的错误身上学习的人是智慧的人。
Drinking makes you mad. To learn this, you don't have to drink.
喝酒会让你疯狂。学习到这一点，你不需要自己去尝试酒精。
There are many guinea pigs in this world who are drinking for you.
这世界上有足够多的小白鼠在帮你做了实验了。
And they have destroyed their life.
他们已经摧毁了他们的生活。
To know that, you don't have to drink yourself.
所以去得到这个智慧，你不需要自己去喝酒。
How the drugs make a man mad? To know that, you don't have to take drugs.
毒品或者说药怎么样人们疯狂你不需要自己去尝试来得到这个结论。
Then I ask her,
然后老师就问他
I said, "You ask your parents, have they done dating before marriage?"
问问你的父母他们是约会之后结婚的吗
And how many years they are married?
然后他们结婚多少年了
They are married for more than 45 years.
他们已经结婚45年之久了。
And see in the society.
See in the society.然后在这个社会当中看
，majority of the young boys and girls they after dating they get married。
很多年轻的男孩女孩约会之后结婚。
And more than 95% of them get divorced。
95%以上的人都离婚。
So this is the data available to you。
这个就是你可以看到的数据。
Now if you are wise enough，
如果你足够聪明的话
，you should follow。The path which your parents have followed, or you should follow the path the fools have followed.
你是应该沿用你父母的体系呢，还是沿用那些愚蠢的人的体系呢
？And look at your parents.
然后看看你的父母。
They don't love each other.
他们不爱对方。
But they understand each other.
但是他们理解对方。
Friends, love is a weakness. Understanding is a strength.
爱是一个弱点，但是理解是力量。
Now.With this much of explanation, you decide whether you want to date or you want to dupe yourself. Choice is yours.
所以这我老师做的这个例子就是来解释我们自己决定应该做什么。How to define the difference between awareness thoughts? Sorry, mind thoughts and awareness.
Awareness with the thoughts is mind.
Consciousness, yeah. Consciousness, 觉知加上思绪就是意识。
And mind without thoughts is consciousness.
意识没有思绪，意识减去思绪就是觉知。
Man with the wife is husband.
一个就是男人加上妻子，他就变成了丈夫。
Husband minus wife is man.
丈夫减去妻子就变成了人。
So when we talk about man and husband, are we talking about two?
当我们说丈夫跟男人，我们是在说两个人吗？
Similarly, when we talk about consciousness and mind, we are not talking about two.
同样的，我们在说意识跟觉知的时候，我们也没有在说两件事。
When thoughts predominate, it is mind.
当我们的觉知里面充满了思绪呢，它就是意识。
And when there is a thought-free experience, it is consciousness.
如果这个意识里面是没有思绪的，那它就是觉知。
Now, right now you experience both.
现在你两者都有体验。
You are looking at me.
你在看着老师。
How do you see me?
你是怎么看老师的？
Through your eyes.
通过你的眼睛。
And what is your experience?
你体验到的是什么？
You see me.
你看到老师。
But you don't think that you are me.
但是你不会觉得你是老师。
So this knowledge where the experience of otherness is valid.
这个体验，这个在你可以观察到的别人的体验是正确的。
That experience is mind.
那个体验就是意识。
For example, this is a cup.
这是一个杯子。
Now how the knowledge takes place?
这里面的智慧或知识是什么？
This is a cup.
这是一个杯子。
I know this is a cup.
我知道这是一个杯子。
But I am not the cup.
但是我不是这个杯子。
Otherwise, what a fun it will be.
不然的话，这会很搞笑，不是吗？
This is a donkey.
这是一头驴。
I know this is a donkey.
我知道这是一头驴。
And I am a donkey.
我也是驴。
This doesn't happen.
这样不会发生。
Therefore, that knowledge where the sense of otherness is predominant, that knowledge is called as mind.
所以这样的知识就是我们是我们自己，但是我们可以体验，可以看到他人。这样的知识就是意识。
Now I ask you a question.
再问大家一个问题。
Do you remember yourself?
你记得你自己吗？
Or do you know yourself?
还是你知道你自己？
What is the difference between remembering and knowing?
记得跟知道什么区别？
In remembrance, there is a possibility of forgetting.
记得就是说你有可能忘记。
In knowing,You don't forget.
知道你就不会忘记。
Because I am.
因为我是。
This is not known through the mind.
因为我是不是通过意识来知道的。
And therefore, we can never experience our absence.
所以我们不会体验自己的缺失。
Therefore, consciousness is that experience where the sense of otherness is not valid.
所以觉知就是我们对他人的那个感受的缺失就是觉知。
And therefore, there is pure love.
所以呢，就只有纯净的爱。
Like the mother sees the child.
就像母亲看到孩子。
The child is other than the mother.
孩子并不是母亲的一部分。
But there is no sense of otherness.
但是他并没有感觉到孩子是别人。
Therefore, a person living at the consciousness level, he will be living in all the differences, but yet he will be at home with everything and everybody.
所以可以存在于觉知层面的人，他知道自己不是他人，但是他还是可以和别人在一起没有区别的生活。
This is the difference between consciousness, mind and thoughts.
这就是意识、思绪跟觉知的区别。We were educated since young, we should think a lot. So during the teaching, the teacher keeps remind us, during the teaching, we cannot stop our thoughts asking questions because you said we shouldn't ask questions. There is the inner voice asking questions. Is this wrong?
When you ask a question to somebody, you will get reply.
当你问别人问题的时候，你会得到一个回复。
You will not get answer.
你不一定得到答案，你会得到一个回复。
Answer you have to discover.
答案要自己去发现。
For example, in a school, when the question paper is given to the student, they have to write answers or replies.
当我们给孩子在上课堂里面给孩子问题的时候，那些孩子们 要回答的是要是答案还是回馈。
They are given the answer books.
然后他们会给一个这个正确的答题卡。
So they have to write the answer.
然后他们会把答案写上去。
So one question was asked in a school examination.
然后其中一个问题是
What is the capital of China?
中国的首都是哪里？
And the student wrote.
然后学生就写
Sir, even this much you don't know, who made you a teacher?
然后呢孩子就问你连中国的首都是哪里都知道你有什么权利做老师
He replied, he did not answer.
他没有回答问题他给了一个反馈
Therefore, when you ask question to somebody, you will not get satisfaction.
所以当你去问一个问题的时候你不一定会被你得到的反馈所满足
And second important point.
第二点非常重要的
Question is always about others.
问题总是关于他人的。
Do you have a question about your being?
你对于自己的存在有疑问吗？
Whether I am or I am not.
我是还是不是？
That's all what matters.
但只有这个其实才是重要的。
Who was the seventh president of America? Do you know?
谁是美国第七任总统？
Doesn't matter.
也没关系，有关系吗？
Does it make any difference?
不会有任何不同。
How many people died in an earthquake in USA?
美国地震的时候有多少人去世了？
I don't know.
不知道。
Never mind.
也没有关系。
But what matters is you must know who you are.
重要的是你要知道你是谁。
Therefore, you have to find out.
所以你要自己去寻找。
Who you are.
你是谁。
And therefore, when you get this habit of asking questions, you will never work on yourself.
因为我们养成了去问问题的习惯了以后，我们就不再能够发现自己我们是谁。
And questions have no end.
问题是永无止境的。
That which is only one, you have no questions.
只有一个你没有问题。
You may have questions about words.
你可能对词汇有问题。
What is the meaning of this word?
这个词是什么意思?
What is the meaning of that word?
那个词是什么意思?
Will you ask a question? What is the meaning of that silence?
你会不会问这个寂静是什么意思?
No question.
没有问题。
When all questions end, you have reached yourself.
当所有的问题都消融了以后，你就回到了自我。
Before we came to this studio,
我们来到瑜伽馆之前
we were having questions whether I will reach on time or not, whether I'll get a bus or not, whether I'll get a taxi or not, whether my train will reach on time or not, going on inside.
在我们到达馆里之前，我们会想今天是几点能到馆里啊？这个公交车会不会准时来啊？地铁会不会晚点啊？很多很多问题。
After you have reached this place, all those questions end, is it not?
当我们到达管理了以后，这些问题全部都消失了，不是吗
？When you come back to your own self, you have no questions.
当你回到了那个自我了以后，这些问题都消失了。
In other words,
用另外的话来说
，When you don't ask questions, you are one with yourself.
当你不问问题的那个状态，没有问题的那个状态，就是和自我在一起。
There is nothing worth knowing in this world.
因为这个世界上没有什么值得被知道。
Therefore, the mantra which I gave you.
老师给的咒是什么
？Whenever I am, wherever I am, whatever I am, I have to be 100%. That is what matters in life.
只有这个是重要的。
Questions will have no end.
问题是不会有永无止境的。
What is the best way to educate kids, especially when you say?Some bad behavior. You remember your childhood and see.
回忆哦，这个问题说的是我那如果孩子是一个不太听话的孩子，那我们应该怎么去教育他们？老师说，想一想你自己的童年。
They are your kids, is it not?
这个里面所指的孩子是你的孩子，是不是
？How do you expect them to be good?
你的孩子你怎么希望他们变好呢
？Don't expect a
他们是好的
tomato.To a chili plant.
不要想一个番茄的籽里面可以长出一个辣椒来。
If the child is problematic, it is the DNA effect.
如果孩子是一个调皮的孩子的话，那是他的 DNA 决定的。
Don't worry too much. They will grow their own way.
不用。
And you relax.
不用太担心，孩子会以自己的方式成长，你放松。
And the most important principle.
特别重要的是。
Children are born through us. They are not born to us.
孩子们不是为我们而生的，而是通过我们而生的。
Like we have got some property which we keep on renting.
就好像我们有一个房子是我们自己的房产，然后我们一直把它租出去。
So that becomes our additional income.
那么就变成我们的一些多余收入。
Now in your that rented property, whatever tenant comes, can you dictate him what he should do?
在你租出去那个房子里面，不管租客是谁，你可以告诉租客该做什么吗？
He may drink, he may not drink.
他可能喝酒，可能不喝酒。
He may make noise, he may keep quiet.
他可能很安静，他可能有些吵。
Now what control you have, what authority you have on the tenant of that house?
你可以对这个房客有什么要求，或者有什么权威要求他做事情吗？
No control.
没有办法控制他。
Exactly the same way.
同样的。
We give to our children only the body to live.
我们只是给了我们的孩子身体来生活。
The one who is living in the body is not created by parents.
那一个在孩子身体当中生活的存在不是父母创造的。
I have 4 sons.
老师有四个儿子。
Eldest one is calm, quiet, studious.
第一个儿子是非常安静，并且刻苦努力工作的。
Second one is the leader type, dictating and fighting everywhere.
第二个是有非常强的性格，是这种领导者的性格。
Third one is a businessman, goes on earning money, cheating others.
第三个是一个商人，赚钱欺骗他人。
And fourth one is good for nothing, therefore is a government servant.
然后第四个一无所成，所以就是一个公务员。
Now all the 4 are my children.
然后四个全部是老师的孩子。
Now how can you explain this?
你怎么解释这一切呢？
For the same tree, there will not be one is mango, other is a tomato, the third is a chili, and the fourth is an apple. Does it happen?
同一棵树，然后它这个树上结下来的果不能一个是芒果，一个是辣椒，一个是西红柿，一个是土豆，这个不对啊。
So.The body-wise, all the 4 sons will look alike.
从身体的层面，这四个儿子都会看起来有很大的相似之处。
But the body is not living life.
但是身体并不是一个生活的主体。
It is the embodied who is living the life.
而是身体当中给身体赋能的那一个，他在生活。
And that embodied is not created by the parents.
那么在身体当中给身体赋能的那一个存在，并不是父母所产生的。
Therefore, if you become miserable because of parents, God bless you.
所以如果你因为你的孩子感觉到悲哀的话，那只能说上祝福你。
Least effort is the right way.
It seems lazy.
Yes, it is the right way.
就是越少的努力就是正确的道路。这个听起来有些懒惰。老师说是的，这就是正确的道路。
Yes, lazy people are intelligent people.
懒惰的人都很聪明。
And lazy people only discover many things.
懒惰的人就发现了，发明了很多事情。
So be lazy.
所以就懒惰吧。
Thank you so much.
感谢。
How to enjoy life when controlling senses?
怎么样享受生活？当我们要控制感官的时候，我们怎么样享受生活
？One of my old friend, he told me one day.
有一个老朋友告诉我，有一天
，Swami, good news.
老师，我有个好消息。
I said, what is the good news?
什么消息啊
？I have given up smoking.
我这个戒烟了。
I said, after how many years?
我问他几年以后你戒烟了
？He said, after 60 years of smoking cigarette.
六十年吸烟历史，我现在戒烟了。
Then I asked him a question.
我就问他一个问题。
The happiness that you had.Of smoking the cigarette for 60 years, and happiness that now you have when you are given up smoking, which is the superior happiness?
我就问他，你吸烟了六十年的快乐和你现在戒烟这段时间的快乐，哪一个快乐更至上？
He said, "You are perfectly right. Now I am more happy than when I was smoking."
然后那个人就说，老师你太对了，我现在比我抽烟的时候要更快乐。
Therefore, you really enjoy the life not when you are indulging, but you are able to remain away.And watch the fools in the world.
所以我们真正可以享受生活，不是我们在生活当中放纵，而是我们可以有能力控制自己，看着别的愚蠢的人在生活当中放纵。Swamiji, since I know you, my life become wonderful. You are a miracle.Your teachings are a gift. How can I share this gift and become a miracle to others? Translate. Swamiji 老师，自从我认识你，我的生活就变得非常的美好。你就是一个奇迹，然后你的教授就是礼物。我怎么样能够分享这一个礼物？然后也变成一个奇迹，把这个奇迹也给予到他人。
We are all the descendants of monkeys, according to Darwin.
根据达尔文的进化论，我们所有人都是猴子的后代。
And monkeys follow mimicry actions.
然后猴子是会互相模仿对方的。
So demonstrate this miracle in your life through action.
所以在你的生活当中，通过行为来展示这个奇迹。
Don't teach anybody in this world.
不要在你的生活当中想要去尝试教育或者教导任何人。
If you have to be with them and demonstrate what really the beautiful life is.
如果你想要做的话，就跟他们在一起，通过行为来展示生活是多么的美好。
There was an old man, he went to Haridwar in India.
有一个人去到印度南部的一个城市。
And there is a tradition when the old people go to that place, they give up something.
然后那一个城市有一个传统，那个有老年人去拜访那个城市的时候，那个城市会放弃某样东西。
So the grandchildren were asking their mother, "Mummy, when grandfather is coming back?"
然后那个孩子就问母亲，那个爷爷什么时候回来啊？
Oh, he is coming tomorrow morning.
然后妈妈就说，后天的早上，明天早上他回来。
Now what he has done there?
然后就说他去那边做了什么
？So the mother told he must have given up something.
那个孩子就说爷爷去了那边以后肯定会放弃某样东西。
So the grandchildren said, "Oh, he must have given up the glasses."
他就说哦，那肯定是把眼镜放弃了。
No, not like that. Something what he likes most or whatever he wants, he can give up.
妈妈就解释不是像这样就把眼镜摘掉，而是你很喜欢的、很珍爱的某些事情，你要把它放掉。
Grandfather came.
爷爷回来了。
Now grandchildren are excited.
然后这个孙子很开心。
And they started asking, "Grandfather, mommy told when you went there, you have given up something."
孩子就问，哦，爷爷，你去到那个地方的传统，你要放弃某些事情，你放弃了什么
？What did you give up?
你放弃了什么
？Oh, my dear child, I have given up anger.
然后就跟孩子说，哦，我放弃了愤怒。
Children.Grandfather, what did you give up when you went there?
那个孩子就说，你去那边的时候，你放弃了什么？
My dear child, I have given up anger.
爷爷又回答，我去那边的时候，我放弃了愤怒。
Grandfather, when you went there, what did you give up?
爷爷，你去那边的时候，你放弃了什么？
I have given up anger.
爷爷就说，我放弃了愤怒。
Grandfather, when you went there, what did you give up?
爷爷，你去那边，你放弃了什么？
I gave up anger.
我放弃了愤怒。
Our teaching is like this.
我们的教授就是这样的。
Don't teach anybody in this world.
不要在这个世界上不要教授任何人。
We should be an ideal model for others.
我们要成为一个行动的榜样。
Demonstrate through life.
通过我们自己的生活去展示。
Or else like that old man.
不然就像那个老那爷爷一样。
That I have given up anger.
他说我放弃了愤怒。
And becomes angry.
然后很快就容易变得，很快容易生气。
Therefore, don't do this mistake of becoming a miracle.
所以不要自己想要变成奇迹。
It will be miserable.
你会变得很糟糕。
attachment can be a source of misery. How to live a detached and content life? By giving up attachment.
执着是我们痛苦的源泉。我们怎么样能够过一种超离的生活，超离而超脱而又满足的生活呢？老师说，放弃执着。
Attachment is an illusion.
执着是一个幻象。
There is no attachment.
这里没有执着。
I am looking at you.
老师看着大家。
Are my eyes attached to you?
老师的眼睛有真正附着在大家或者执着于大家吗？
Our childhood has gone.
我们的童年时代已经过去了。
Are we attached to the childhood?
我们还执着于或者说附着于我们以前的童年时代吗？
When we go to sleep.
当我们睡觉的时候。
Are we attached to our body?
我们还附着于执着于我们的包体吗？身体吗？
Attachment is an illusion.
执着是一个幻象。
Come to know this.
要知道它。
So I am attached is a total lie. Nobody is attached to anything.
就是说我没有什么东西是活不了的，这个完全是一个谎言，这个是不对的。
One old man died.
有一个老年人他过世了。
And his wife was crying.
然后他的妻子在哭。
Oh, without you I cannot live.
就是说你不在了，你不要我怎么活呀？
I think I will also die.
我也会随你而去的。
Oh God, why don't you take me also?
为什么你不带着我一起走呢？
And he was crying, crying, crying.
哭啊哭啊哭啊。
And all the young children,
他们年轻的孩子，
they were waiting after the man was buried.
等到那个身体被埋葬了以后，
now the children were waiting, come on, the old lady will also go.
然后在等这个 年迈的妈妈也走，
because she was telling, without him I cannot live.
因为他们在等着他也走，就是他也往生，因为他说了他不在我是活不下去的。
Now one day has gone, one month has gone, one year has gone.
一天过去了，一个月过去了，一年过去了。
And she is not going.
谁还没有走？他还是没有走。
One day the children ask.
有一天孩子又问他，
Mama, you said without him you cannot live. When are you going to die?
妈妈，你说了爸爸走了以后，你一天也活不下去，你什么时候走啊？
Attachment is an illusion. Don't get carried away by the wrong word. We are not attached to anything.
执着是一个幻象，不要被执着这个词所带走。我们所有的人都不执着。
Living with this wisdom is living in knowledge.
带着这样的智慧去生活。
Thank you very much. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Avashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om